What's going on, subway surfers? We're back on the surface today for our series, Random Transiting. For this series, we explore a random bus stop, route, or other notable transit facility. Take a look at some interesting facts about the chosen transit feature. For this edition, we're taking a look at Toronto's biggest subway interchange at Spadina Station. I'm Zach with Vantage Underground, and let's take a look. Spadina Station is located near the intersection of Spadina Road and Bloor Street West in downtown Toronto. Originally opened in 1966, the station services roughly 45,000 daily passengers and has seen two major expansions since its opening. The first part of the station opened in 1966, consisting of the two side platforms for the Bloor-Danforth line, as well as two street entrances on either side of Spadina Road north of Bloor. In 1978, the station was expanded to include two new side platforms on the Yonge-University-Spadina line, as well as two new street entrances on either side of Spadina Road at Kendall Avenue. At the same time, a new off-street bus terminal opened, replacing the east entrance to the station north of Bloor. In 1997, an underground streetcar platform was added, and the Bloor-Danforth platforms were outfitted with elevators to street level. Finally, in 2000, a fifth entrance was added to the station, with a new street-level building on the east side of Walmer Road, north of Bloor. All five entrances remain open and in use today, with only the entrance through the bus terminal being designated as accessible. The station features many unique aspects that set it apart from other subway stations in Toronto. Between the platforms for Line 1 and Line 2, a long corridor runs underneath Spadina Road, with a fare paid area connecting the two lines. Prior to 2004, a moving sidewalk ran through this corridor, with traces of the old walkway still visible today in the tile work. A collector's booth is located in the bus terminal, with the remaining entrances of the station being controlled only by fare gates. A small concession stand is located on the south concourse, between the stairs for Line 2 and the streetcar platform. At the east entrance out to Kendall Avenue from Line 1, the station entrance was incorporated into a heritage property, with the subway being accessed through the building and a bus stop being added in front. Two art pieces are also incorporated into the Kendall Avenue entrance, with a mural at the aforementioned heritage building and a quilt displayed in the north concourse just beyond the fare gates. Various transit services have connected to the subway at Spadina, providing service to the neighborhoods in the area. At the opening of the subway, the 77 Spadina bus stopped in front of the station on street, running between Dupont and Lakeshore 24 hours a day. With the opening of the Spadina subway extension on Line 1, a new bus terminal was opened in 1978, allowing the 77 bus to loop off street. North of Spadina Station, service on the 77 was replaced by the 103 Spadina North bus, which ran north from the bus terminal to Davenport. The 103 route included two new stops on street at the Line 1 entrance at Kendall Avenue. Service on the 103 continued until 1984, when it was replaced by the 127 Davenport, which continues to operate to Spadina Station to this day. In 1987, overnight service on Spadina was replaced by the Blue Night Route 317, running south from Spadina Station to Queens Quay. While overnight service was discontinued in 1992, daytime service on the 77 Spadina continued until 1997, when it was replaced by the newly opened 510 Spadina streetcar. This route used the new underground loop, descending underground into the station just south of Bloor. Overnight service on the 317 Spadina restarted in 2015, meaning that the main entrance of Spadina Station was now open for 24 hours a day. The 317 Spadina was renumbered to the 310 shortly afterwards. Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed and perhaps found a new place to check out on your next adventure. If you have any questions or we got anything wrong, leave us a comment down below and we'll be sure to get back to you. Feel free to leave a like if you want to see more. And as for us here, we'll be Vanished Underground until the next one.